The welcome for the team at the top of the tree, and in particular for the man generally reckoned to be Everton's most valuable player. Peter Reid, past fit, for all the fact that he carries a few scars, and he continues his run of consecutive appearances to 88. Everton's collective strength is surely the balance of the side, particularly in midfield. The Kendall, Ball and Harvey trio of the 1970 Championship side is succeeded now by a quartet who incidentally between them have contributed 29 goals to the side's total of 84. For their third cup tie in 6 days, Ipswich could reasonably wish for a less daunting task. Steve McCall has recovered from Wednesday's injury, but not Mitch Davray. And what does fate hold for the man who replaces him, Alan Sunderland, who on Monday came off the substitutes bench to score the winner in the FA Cup against Sheffield Wednesday. On Wednesday, missed a golden opportunity which might have beaten Norwich in the Milk Cup. What now? The referee with the FIFA badge is Alan Robinson from Waterlooville in Hampshire. Well, I think it's generally known that Everton have not lost a match in 1985, but for the record, they haven't lost an FA Cup tie on this ground for 10 years. Everton attacking the goal to our left. Andy Gray gets his first touch, and a good one. Scored a hat-trick in the Cup Winners' Cup in midweek. Second one, a typical Gray goal. Dive with his head low at the far post. It's Kevin Ratcliffe. It's Eric Mountfield, who scored last Saturday at Old Trafford. Curran. He's given the free kick for the challenge by McCall on Trevor Stephen. Gray and Curran in the box. Well won by Terry Butcher. Ran into Butcher. He was hoping for a free kick, he didn't get it. And here's Curran again. Oh, well played by Butcher, but the referee has given an indirect free kick for obstruction against the Ipswich captain. Really for the use of the left arm. Judged to have held off Curran, and suddenly found he was back in possession after having an appeal for an earlier free kick turned down. Reid and Sheedy on the ball. Gray and Curran on the far side, so is Stephen, so is Mountfield, who's met by Cranston. That's a test for Cooper. Free kick given against Gray. Got to the goalkeeper first. He claims he won it with his head. One of those terribly difficult ones for referees. But the referee has to give things as he sees them. And Mr. Robinson was ideally placed and said that Gray made contact first with the goalkeeper. Burley, Sunderland, Zondervan couldn't make it. Van den Howe, Curran, Reid. How could he have known that Bracewell was coming? What a ball to Gray! Handball by Paul Cooper. That was some brilliant play by Everton, because Reid just played the ball into the space and Bracewell made, what, 10 or 12 yards. And Bracewell played it instantly, the ball curling away from the oncoming goalkeeper towards Andy Gray, and Paul Cooper forced to handle outside his area. Sheedy takes and scores! No, said the referee. I didn't tell him to take it. So two in the net for Everton and neither counts. Burley coming forward. The ball's been taken slightly further back and Gates is complaining about that. Well, that makes a change. Sheedy again, goes for the other side. Brilliant! not an earthy for Paul Cooper. But what a lesson in taking free kicks by Kevin Sheedy. Almost said to Mr. Robinson, I don't mind if you don't allow me to put it in one corner, I'll put it in the other. 6 minutes, the cup holders, the potential champions, the unbeaten side in the country, take the lead. And what a lovely goal. Sheedy's 13th of the season. Curran. Backlift to Sheedy. There are some magic moments from Everton here. Stephen. Everything's coming off. Stevens. Gray. Inches over the top. And he gets up to a shout of oh bother. Listen to the noise around Goodison Park. Gray has gone to the far side. Mountfield is behind him. Mountfield challenged well by Butcher. Stephen, Reed, Stevens. Play by Bracewell. Put in game from Putney. Zondervan. Sheedy getting back to force a change of direction. And here's Wilson. That's a good shot! And it goes through Neville Southall, who up till now has been a spectator. Don't think, to judge from Kevin Wilson's expression, that he can quite believe it. But it wasn't a truly hit shot, and it squirmed its way underneath Neville Southall for one apiece. Goal in the 15th minute, and to be truthful, making nonsense of the balance of play in that first 15 minutes. So Everton have to start again. And Terry Butcher's side with renewed heart. It was on this ground that Terry Butcher made his debut in April 1978, just before Ipswich won the cup. And today he makes his 300th senior appearance for the club. Three up for Ipswich. Brennan, Burley. Southall's played so well for Everton during the season, but a goalkeeper cannot afford to make even one error. I'm afraid that one will haunt him if Everton can't put it right for him. Brendan Hart. Stephen. Well, Reed. Lovely little chip from Ratcliffe. Bracewell unmarked in the middle. It's a happy knack of getting forward unobserved. the call. Johnson bowling up the hill. Butcher did well. Zondervan! Lovely goal! Lovely set piece goal. Butcher, the key man in that. A very good throw. Butcher's flicked header to Zondervan, who shot instantly. And the ball curling past South Hall. And Ipswich, who for the first quarter of an hour were on the rack against some brilliant football from the home side, are now in front with 32 minutes gone. Bracewell. Brandon Howe. Well claimed. Ian Cranston, who took the throw. He's got a battle on his hands against Andy Gray, but certainly used his long throw to great effect then. Butcher. Brandon. Partly was flattened by Reed, a little late. Zondervan. He's given a free kick against Sheedy, and that surely will be a booking. Zondervan was clear, and Sheedy got his ankle, not the ball. With George Burley on the ball, Brennan just behind him to his left, Gates the other way. Butcher beaten to it by Gray. And I should think we'll see Gray come back quite often. Offside. Ball was out of play. Sheedy giving Everton the lead. Wilson getting the equaliser, a mistake by Neville Southall. Zondervan giving Ipswich a 2-1 lead. The match turning on a mistake by Kevin Southall, and summarised really that first half by the fact that Kevin Sheedy, so prominent at the start, was in the end the player booked to deny Ipswich a promising chance of a third goal. All credit to Bobby Ferguson's side, who picked themselves up not only from the defeat by Norwich in the Milk Cup, but also by the start that Howard Kendall's Everton made in this match. With his expression, rather sums up their feelings. Started so well, but start the second half, 1-2 down. Gray underneath it. Cooper in trouble, no whistle. And Sunderland seemed to me to play Brandon Howell, then not the ball. Wilson. Referee played the advantage, and here's Ratcliffe. Can't believe it either. Seemed to have got past Cooper. Cooper, with apparent simplicity, just said, no, I'll have it, thank you very much. Brennan. Oh, Reed. Some lucky ricochet. Curran. Gray! No! The goal was yawning. And he stays an awful long time with his hands behind his head. And the front part of his head missed a golden chance. Wilson, up comes Putney. Worth having a crack. Wilson to the left, he does go for the crack. The corner. Putney, Reed. Reed again. Booking. And it's not a booking, it is a sending off. And away goes Steve McCall. Sheedy underneath it. Bracewell. Reed. Stephen. Gray far side. Reed in the middle of the box. Stephen still with the chance. And the referee says no. And the linesman didn't react either. And I must say, I find that very difficult to understand, because it was a genuine attempt by Stephen to get round his man. And it seemed to me that he was certainly tripped at the end of it. Otherwise, he would surely have carried on. He was so certain he was going to get the penalty. Reed. Yes, he's made the gap. Van den Hau. Yes! Mountfield has done it! The hold on the cup has been re-established. Van den Hau crossed it. And Mountfield, who potted home. And the defenders have saved Everton. Of huge relief, and on the other bench those